Hi everyone, my name is JMLisondra, and by using limited colors in my palette, I am going to teach you on how to paint this wonderful painting. And please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Okay, so before I'm going to start the tutorial, I'm going to introduce to you first the materials that I'm going to use. So I still be using limited colors my palette, and I have the titanium white, the phthalo blue, the brilliant red, the medium yellow, and the raw umber. So I'm using limited colors my palette because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. And if you're using burnt umber and burnt sienna, that will be fine, but if you're using the burnt sienna, you can mix it with blue and red to make it dark or look like black. And if you're using the burnt umber and the raw umber, just mix it with blue to make it dark, or if you want to have black. Okay, so these are my brushes. I will be using number 12 nylon flat brush long handle, number 8 nylon flat brush long handle, number 7 nylon flat brush short handle, and I have here the smallest brush, which is the number 3 nylon flat brush short handle. You can also use 0.0 to 0.0, but I think this process will be enough for this tutorial. Okay, and this is my canvas. It's 8 by 10 inches. It's 3 coats of prime white acrylic. You can also use GSO. I made it myself. And water to thin the paint. And water spray, so that we can make our canvas wet and it will be easier for us to blend the colors. Okay, I think that's it. So I think I'm going to start now, and today I'm going to paint as a close-up waterfalls. It will be a small waterfall from a river or from a stream, and yeah, this I just make a very close-up waterfall today. So if you're painting with me, just follow them to me. Just follow what I'm doing, and good luck guys, and just relax and enjoy. Okay, so first we're going to sketch the waterfall, or the, so we're going to sketch first what elements or what objects we're going to put. So we're going to put some waterfall, of course, and rocks, few rocks. Okay, so this will be for the beginners. It will be just and easy, but we're going to do our best to make it realistic. So I'm going to use some raw umber for the sketching, and the number 8 flat brush here. I'm going to put a very huge rock here. Yes, then we're gonna put the waterfall here in the center of this rock. I'm gonna put another rock here, a few rocks in the below the waterfall, and another rock here, small, big, there. So this will be the pattern. So I'm using the raw umber. Okay, so I think I'm gonna start painting now. I'm going to use the bigger brush to make it faster, and I'm gonna use some raw umber and blue color to make it dark or black. There. There. Okay, and I want here. That's it. I'm gonna use some umber. There. So we need to block first the areas, so we're going to put some dark tones. Okay. And I'm gonna use the raw umber and some white. It's gonna make it a little lighter. There. I'm gonna make it a little darker. So I think I'm gonna make this part dark behind the waterfall. So I think I just cover this part darker tones or darker colors. So remember guys that we're gonna put the waterfall here on this part, but first we're going to cover it with some dark color. If it feels hard, just dip the tip of your brush into the water to make it wet. Here. So we need to put some lighter color here. We need to add the blocking of colors. That's always be the first step. So this is just the background colors guys, and later we're gonna put the highlights. That's it. Okay. And also the other one here. The other rock. Okay. And now I'm going to mix some brownish or greenish color. So I'm gonna use this brown with some blue and yellow there, so it will be a little greenish. This part will be the water, and also I'm gonna put some brown in it. When you say water, it doesn't mean that you gonna make it blue or green. Doesn't mean that you're gonna paint it with green or blue. Okay. And add some blue. You need to mix lots of colors in it. That's how you're gonna make. But it depends on the clarity of the water. Sometimes it will become brown. Those are the dirty waters. But greens, there are lots of algae in the water. So here we're gonna put some blocks of colors here. Dark colors, greenish or bluish color, and add some blue. Okay, I think I'm done with the first coats or the background tones. So next we're going to start adding some more details. So I'll be using the smaller brush, which is the number 8 flat brush. Okay. First we need to put some water here, or green stone. So I'm gonna use this green tone here with some white to make it lighter, and I'm gonna put some water here, just add some lighter color using this lighter green color on the top of the waterfall. Okay, and I'm going to use some blue and white there. And black, some blue color. And then we're gonna put some highlights here. Some bluish highlights. There. These highlights are the reflection coming from the above light. It will become a little bluish in color. I think we're gonna make it a little more bluish, so I'm gonna add more blue there. Okay, about that. And here we're gonna put some more bluish tone there. So I'm using the number 8 flat brush. So all you have to do is just blend it there. Okay, just do it little by little, and again do not overdo it there. About that, and I'm going to add a very bright line here with the same color. That's it. And also here, I'm gonna put some a little amount of highlights. Okay, now I'm gonna make this part dark here. So I'm gonna use some raw umber, yellow and blue to make it greenish. So here, I think it should be darker, so I'm gonna add more blue. Should have more blue there. Just add some bluish tone here to make it darker. Okay, and of course here I think I'm gonna make it a little bluish. one also here. Okay, how about that? And here, gonna put a little. And I'm gonna add more greens, add some mosses. Yeah. I'm gonna add some more greens. Yes, that's it. I'm gonna do it slowly to make it look realistic. And here. More mosses, and on the other one here, just make it green. I like it green. Okay, I'm gonna do my best to make this painting look realistic. Okay. That's it. And I'm gonna add more green here. There. And I think I'm gonna use now the smaller brush, this is the number 7 flat brush, to add more smaller details. And I will be using more white and this bluish color here. And some blue. Let's make this lighter. Okay, that's it. And this part here. There. Okay, and the other one here. Okay. So as you can see, we can now see clearly the rocks. How the stones and also the one here. There. And of course. One here. Okay, now I'm gonna mix for brown, so I'm gonna use this. Okay, you need to clean your brush first. I need to use some umber, yellow, and red. So it's now brown, and I'm gonna add more white on it. And I'm gonna put some brown here. There. So I'm gonna do it slowly, little by little. I'm gonna use this brush so that we can have smaller details. We can put more details in there, on this. Okay. That's it. Okay, here. Not lighter tone. And let's put more here. Okay, about that. Yes, I think that looks realistic. Okay, what else? So here. So here I'm gonna put more yellow. Oh no, blue, sorry. And here, you know. I'm going to put some rocks on the distance, okay? And I'm gonna use more brown, and I'm gonna put here a little brown to make it. To add more brownish tone on this rock, and I'm going to continue here. There, that looks realistic. And also here. Actually, the light is coming from the top. So usually the forest, when it is on the bottom of the forest, the lights or the sunlight is coming from the always on the top, mostly on the top. Okay. So here. So continue adding, guys. And I think you should not forget this part here. I think I'm going to mix, I'm going to use the raw umber and the white. Yeah. And let's add more highlights. I think I'm going to make it darker. I'm gonna add more umber to make it darker. There. And I'm gonna add more white again. It's become shinier on this part. And again, guys, do not overdo it. Make some more textures. So that's just like what I'm doing. I'm adding more textures on the rocks. That's why I'm using smaller brush. Okay, now I'll be using again this. I'm gonna mix the brown here and the blue and adding more white. And I'm gonna make this part shinier, lighter. There. Again, you need to use the smaller brush. Okay, Okay, I'm going to make this part light, shinier or lighter. There, and also this one here. Okay, about that. Okay, that's it. So I think that looks realistic now. And now I think I'm going to start adding the waterfall slowly. And I'll be using this raw umber and the blue color. I'm gonna mix it with a little amount of blue and some white to make it lighter. Yes. So do not make it too light, just enough. Okay. It should look like mostly gray. So here, we're gonna put the waterfall here. Yes, that's it, guys. It is a small waterfall. So we need to create some textures in it, not just straight lines, but a few textures. There. And also here. Okay, now we're going to add some more foams or white foams on the bottom. Let's extend more here. So you can actually use a bigger brush. Okay, maybe I'm going to use a bigger brush later. There. And now I'm going to add more white. Okay, and a little amount of blue to make it bluish. Yes. And let's add more foam reflection here. Okay, do not overdo it, guys. There. This is a reflection from the light from the above, okay? There. Sorry guys. There. And let's put more light on the waterfall. There. That's it. I think that looks realistic now. Well, let's add more. Yes. And here. Here. Also here. There. Okay, let's add more details. Okay. Let's also add some reflection on the distance here. Yes. Okay, I think I'm gonna make it more detailed. Okay, and I'm going to add a little yellow orange on this and more white. There. This time a little lighter. Okay. I know I'll be using a bigger brush. It is the number 8 flat brush, and I'm gonna create the foams on the river. So I'm gonna add more white here. So I'm gonna make it circular on the strokes. There. I'm gonna make this a little chaotic. So just create circular strokes using this flat brush. There. And also here. Yes, and I'm gonna add more white on it. There, okay. About that. And I'm gonna use some more yellowish tone here. I'm gonna use this umber here, and I'm gonna add some yellow and red to make it brown. And let's add some more brownish tone here. There. This is the color of the rock behind the waterfall. Behind the edge of the rock where the waterfall falls. Okay. Here. There. And of course we're gonna put some underwater rocks. So I'm gonna use this brown here. I'll be using the bigger brush, it is the number 8 flat brush. And some raw umber and blue color. So just blend here. Okay. And I'm gonna use some more greens here to add some underwater rocks to make this river look shallow. There. Okay. And using this raw umber and some more blue color, I'm gonna make this. I'm gonna retouch this part. There. And more lighter tones, I'm gonna retouch here. And of course here we're gonna put some more darker tones. Yeah. Okay. Yes, I think that looks realistic. And I think I'm gonna retouch more, and then I'm gonna use a smaller brush. It is the number 3 flat brush. I'm gonna add more white here. I'm gonna mix it with the existing bluish gray color. And I think I'm gonna need to retouch this one to make it more realistic. I'm gonna make the water dance with a zigzag strokes, and also here. There, just follow what I'm doing, guys, and just enjoy. Okay. And I'll be using more white, and let's add some more reflection here. There. And of course here. Let's make this part brighter. And here also. Okay. And it's gonna make this part lighter. here. I'm gonna add more white foams on the water. So here. I'm gonna add more white foams. There. Okay. Okay, that's it. Now the last part will be the adding the details of the rock here on this bottom before we're gonna forget that. So I'm gonna add more white on this brown here, and let's add more highlight here. You can use the tapping and pounding technique. And we're gonna add some more green stone there and red. Just use the tapping and pounding technique to create the textures. Okay, that's all of it, and I think I am done. Yes, I think I am done, guys. So yes, so I think I am done with this simple tutorial, and I hope you get something out of this, and I hope you learn. So again, once again, guys, honestly, thank you for watching this video today, and my advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn to mix and get the desired colors you want. Okay. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Once again, guys, thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you all.